Hello, I am Almirali Guerrero Sanchez, and this is the training portion of the video. Here you will learn how to recognize an opioid overdose, how to administer the life-saving antidote naloxone, and what to do after an overdose. How do you recognize an opioid overdose? If someone appears unconscious and unresponsive, you would want to try to wake them up. You might need to try to shout their name, going up and touching them, making sure that they're okay. If they are not responding to that, they might be experiencing an overdose. A reminder, symptoms of an overdose can include pinpoint pupils, slow or shallow breathing, strange noises if someone is struggling to breathe, and cold or discolored skin, especially around the mouth, the fingers, and the eyes. The very first thing you will want to do is call 911. Say that there is a medical emergency and the person is unconscious and unresponsive. Provide them with your location and an exact address if possible. Stay on the phone with the operator, but tell them you are going to administer naloxone and set down the phone. You will need to give rescue breaths and prepare the first dose of naloxone. First, you want to get everything out of your kit out. You have the 3 syringes, 3 alcohol wipes, 3 vials, the breathing barrier, and your gloves. This is what the breathing barrier looks like. It provides a very clear diagram so you can see exactly where to place it over a person's face and mouth. Lay the breathing barrier over the victim's face as a protective layer. Tilt their chin up slightly in order to open up their airway. Make a tight seal over the person's mouth with your own and blow steadily into their mouth for about 1 second. If you see that the stomach is rising instead of the chest, you should reposition the angle of the chin and try again. Give 2 solid rescue breaths, then move into the first dose of naloxone. Get your naloxone ready. We're showing you the IM intramuscular injection form of naloxone. It comes with a vial and a syringe. Each vial of naloxone has an orange cap. You will need to remove this cap. You should be able to pop it off using your thumb or pulling it with your nails. Open up the syringe and take it out of the wrapper. Next, to remove the safety cap, you should pull it straight off. But if you try to twist it or turn it, you might remove the needle. Holding the syringe firmly in one hand, pull the safety cap with your other and set it down so that you can recap the syringe once you have administered the injection. There is a gray rubber stopper on each of the vials of naloxone. This is where you will insert the needle. First, pull a little bit of air into the syringe by pulling back the plunger, and then insert the tip of the needle into the vial. Inject the air to create a vacuum inside of the vial. Make sure that the tip of the needle is below the liquid line and pull all of the medication into the syringe. Since this injection is going into the muscle and not the vein, you don't really have to worry about the air bubbles in the medication. There are 3 recommended areas of the body for this type of injection, all of which have large muscle groups. The best 2 are either the upper outer arm or the outer thigh. If for whatever reason these 2 areas are not accessible, you can also inject into the upper and outer quadrants of the buttocks. The needle can penetrate light layers of clothing, but ideally you should pull back the clothing to expose the skin and sterilize the injection site using one of the provided alcohol wipes. Firmly insert the needle into the target area. Keeping the syringe at a 90 degree angle to the injection site, you should do this in one solid motion. Try to make sure you are getting past the outer skin and into the fat layer and into the muscle. Push down on the plunger to inject all the medication into the muscle and then pull the needle straight out. Being very careful to not poke yourself with the used needle, you're going to put the needle back into the safety cap. Some people find it helpful to put one arm behind their back while recapping to avoid using their other hand. Click it into place to seal it shut and set aside for when the first responders arrive. Continue to provide rescue breaths after the first injection. You will give 1 breath every 5 seconds for about 2 minutes. This is how long it typically takes for naloxone to have an effect. If after 2 minutes has passed and the victim has not improved, you will prepare another dose of naloxone and repeat the earlier steps. Alternate between rescue breathing and giving naloxone. If the naloxone reverses an overdose, the victim can come out of an overdose state every suddenly. The victim will essentially be in an immediate opiate withdrawal, which can include vomiting, disorientation, and body aches. It is important to stay with the victim until medical help arrives and make sure they do not try to use more opiates. Once the naloxone wears off, they can slip back into an overdose if there are still opiates present in their system. If and when you feel comfortable doing so, you may consider encouraging the victim to seek additional treatment if they feel they might have a substance use disorder. That concludes this naloxone training. Thank you so much for taking the time to educate yourself on naloxone and how it can be used to reverse the opiate overdose. If you are in need of an I Am Naloxone kit, please reach out to the Steve Rellner Hope Network or visit our website to find a map of partnered locations where you can get naloxone.